Hello everyone, this is Brian or GamerMaster01 coming at you with a special video where I decided to play King's Quest for you guys, because King's Quest is one of my favorite series. I know it's kind of out of my realm of you guys choosing the game for me to play, but I thought I'd treat everyone to the King's Quest series over a period of time. So in between game votes, I'll just randomly play random King's Quest games in order. So that way you can kind of immerse yourself in the King's Quest world, I guess you could say. Anyhow, so this game is King's Quest 1. This is the remake that a company called AGD made, which is basically the original game, but totally revamped. As you'll notice, this is not DOS-based. This is Windows-based, GUI. Look at the pretty graphics. So the cool thing is they kept the original music creator. They added new stuff, they changed portraits, they added audio voices. It's very much like if you ever played like King's Quest V, that kind of style. And this is what we're going to start with. We'll start with King's Quest 1. It's a dramatic opening there. Oh yeah! King's Quest 1, Quest for the Crown. Okay, I believe we shall start with the introduction so everyone knows what's going on.
You are Sir Graham, the bravest and most honorable knight in the troubled realm of Daventry. King Edward the Benevolent, aged ruler of Daventry, has summoned you to the castle for reasons unknown.
Greetings, Sir Graham. The King is expecting you. Allow me to escort you to His Majesty's throne room.
Thank you, Sir Knight.
Oh, yeah. I like me.
Raise the portcullis.
I like me some Graham.
I am at your service, my king.
I am an old man, Sir Graham. Perhaps too old to carry the weight of this crown. My bones ache, my hands tremble. I am afraid my time on Earth grows short. But enough about me. Great misfortunes have befallen Daventry since the loss years ago of three magical treasures. I have chosen you, the finest knight in all of Daventry, to search for these lost treasures. Only then can this kingdom be restored to its former glory. And only then may I rest with the knowledge that my people are safe. The first treasure is a magic mirror that foretells the future. The second is a magical shield that protects the bearer from all mortal harm. The third and last is an enchanted chest that is forever filled with gold. I know that what I ask is difficult, nay, perhaps impossible. The dangers are many, but you are brave and pure of heart. That is why I chose you to volunteer. If you succeed, you will inherit my crown and rule the realm of Daventry as her rightful king. Go, Sir Graham. And know that the fate of Daventry lies in your hands.
Take heart, my king. I shall not fail you.
Alright, guys. So now we're going to start King's Quest, Quest for the Crown. Hope you guys are ready for this. Would you like to play the game without the possibility of encountering dead ends or getting stuck? Yes. Now, here's the other thing about the later King's Quest games. They don't give you this option. So you might be in the middle of a room and you can't actually escape unless you have the right items or equipment. So it's really annoying in later games, and I have a film I do those ones. You'll see a lot of cutouts of when I had to restart the whole game over again because I needed certain items. Now, in this game, it's impossible to get stuck. But I am purposely going to die or do stupid stuff so I can hear the funny commentary. So we're going to do this though without getting stuck so that doesn't happen this time through, okay?
You have disabled dead ends. The game will be fully playable from beginning to end. and you will never get into a situation where you are forced to restart from the beginning.
Thank God. Alright guys, let's start my adventure. Now, one thing if you guys aren't familiar with the King's Quest series is a few things. One, it is computer-based, obviously. You'll see my little icon moving around. I'm moving the mouse here. This actually can change from a little guy walking, a little eyeball icon, a little, I don't know, grab hand action, you know what I'm saying? And then the talk icon. If I hold my mouse all the way to the very top, a menu appears. All those same icons are here. This is usually the most previously used item I have equipped. My bag, I can open up, and
you
I can
are carrying nothing.
Well, okay, well, so I'm carrying nothing right now, but in the future I can carry stuff. I don't really know what the question mark does. I don't think I've ever clicked that. Oh, okay, that just tells me how to do stuff. Okay, well, let's. I know how to play the game. Oh, okay. Anyways. Okay. So you notice there's a little pink dot on his foot. Wherever I click, that's where he will walk. Yes, it's kind of an old school kind of game, but honestly, when I was a kid, I played King's Quest V. It was my very first one. I loved it. And so I decided to play them all. I've only actually beaten this one, and I think I beat part 2 and 5. So I'm going to try to play them all in order. I haven't played this one in forever, so I'll probably make a million mistakes. Bear with me. One thing I will change, because he does like to walk really slow, I'm going to make his movement speed a little bit quicker here. Not all the way up. Sometimes I do it all the way up, but usually I'll do it like around here. Sounds I'll bring down. Speech is the most important. It's the funniest thing of all. We're going to save this. We're going to call this Rune. Let me delete that. It's an old file. Okay. There we go. And boom. So now I want to walk him a little bit quicker. One other thing I want to point out, too, is in the very top right up here. I'm not going to move it all the way up because the menu will pop up like that. You'll see a 0 of 158. This is a possible score at the end of the game. The higher score, the better you did, or the more clever your actions were. Generally, when you're playing the game, if you give someone the wrong item or you do something incorrectly, that number goes down. You never really want to do that. You want to make sure you give them the correct item. So in this case, I'm starting the game fresh. No points. Let's get started. So these guys look interesting. Let me just kind of take a look at them.
These guards protect the king's castle. These guards protect the king's castle. This deep swampy moat is patrolled by vicious serpents.
Okay, what about this grass?
You are standing outside King Edward's castle, which is surrounded by a serpent-filled moat.
What about these vines?
The castle walls are carpeted with a thick tangle of vines.
Okay, well, let's try touching the guards.
Don't disturb the guards. Best to get on with your mission.
Ha!
You wouldn't want to dive into the serpent-filled moat.
Yeah, it's funny. You say that, but part of me kind of wants to walk into the moat.
The moat monsters appreciate your good taste.
I see what they did there. All right. You guys want to talk at least?
These stone-faced guards must have been trained not to converse with anybody. They ignore you, Sir Graham.
All right. Well, then I guess we're leaving this screen. So when I have to explore these games, I usually actually go right to left. I don't know why I usually go left to right, but let's just start taking a little quick walk to the right. If there's anything of interest, I'll usually explore it. Otherwise, I'll just keep moving on. Because usually if there's something interesting, I want to grab it or do something. Like, for example, this looks kind of suspicious.
The sunlight glistens on the rippling water.
Okay.
There are strong currents under the calm surface of this lake. Diving here would be too dangerous. That's strange. You don't get an answer.
Well, I guess the water's not talking to me today. So in this case, there's nothing really other of interest on this screen, so I'm going to continue moving on. I like to save it every now and then. You'll see me save this a million times probably in this video. Oh, that looks interesting.
A small spring bubbles up from the rocks here and splashes into the lake. You would need to have much bigger hands to stop this spring from flowing. That's strange. You don't get an answer. This is just one of the many small trees adorning Daventry's countryside. That's strange. You don't remember this rock being here in the EGA version.
Oh, they added a rock. Ooh.
The rock is far too heavy to move. There is nothing up there you'll need.
Okay, so far nothing too exciting going on here, so let's go to the next screen. Okay, I see two things of interest here. One is this stump. The second is this fallen down log. Let's take a look in the stump.
Inside the rotting stump, you notice a small leather pouch.
So see how I gained a point? That was a good action. Let me try grabbing it.
As you lift the pouch from the stump, you feel its contents shifting inside.
Okay, so now I got a bag. And see how the points went up, so that's good. Okay, what's the point of the bag, though?
When you peek inside the leather pouch, you discover it's filled with diamonds.
Oh, well, that's gotta be good. Oh, points went up. That's a good sign.
Cautiously, you open the pouch and see many sparkling and flashing diamonds. Quickly, you close it again so as not to lose any.
Okay, well, so far so good. What about in here?
Next to you is an old fallen tree trunk. It's crumbling and rotted and holds no interest for you. Unless you have a fascination with termites.
I very well may.
There is no reason to take this old log with you.
Okay, well, I guess that's it for this screen. But now I got an item, so I'm going to save it. Let's continue on, shall we? I see a well in the background, but I like to go left to right before I go up and down. So I'm going to keep moving here.
This is a serene mountain lake. In the woods to the north, you can just see what looks like an old stone well.
Okay. Let's keep going to the right. Ooh, this looks interesting.
This is a serene mountain lake with a small beach of pebbles on its edge.
Okay, so the pebbles are interesting, I guess.
This is a serene mountain lake.
Can I grab them?
The water is not deep. There's not much.
Aha!
Pebbles.
So now I've got pebbles. Now I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. It would have a point, so it's, can I hit myself on them?
There's not much you can do with a handful of pebbles right here. This is not a good place to throw rocks.
Okay, so we'll save the rocks for later. I'm sure I'll need them later. Now this looks interesting here too. I see a random rock.
You see a large gray rock.
Yes, as I just pointed out, there's a large gray rock.
To avoid injury, perhaps you should try pushing the rock from the northern side.
Okay, well, let's go to the northern side.
With a small shove, you manage to push the rock a few feet, revealing a shallow hole underneath.
Okay, well, let's take a look in the hole.
There is an intricately carved dagger in the hole.
Well, you damn know what I'm gonna do.
You reach into the hole and grasp the dagger, being careful not to cut yourself.
All right, look at that.
Be careful, Sir Graham. You might cut yourself.
All right. Let's save it. So far, I'm already a tenth of the way through this game. So it's not a very long game. Most of them aren't. As long as you just, you know, kind of go through it here. Oh. Okay, so it looks like I kind of looped around. I'm guessing, right? Yeah. So Daventry's not very big. Apparently, he goes in a circular pattern. So now we'll go, let's go down the next layer, I guess you could say. Okay, can I go left? Okay, I can't go left, so this is as far left as I can go. So let's go right. The bridge, actually...
The small, rickety wooden bridge is very old, but quite solid enough to support many times your weight. If you wish to cross the bridge, Sir Graham, simply walk over it.
Okay, I don't trust that. It sounds too easy. I knew it!
As you start to cross the bridge, a huge, hulking troll stomps into view and blocks your way. This is the ugliest, meanest, nastiest troll you have ever seen, and he's not about to let anybody cross his bridge. You push the troll as hard as you can. Unfortunately, the troll doesn't budge an inch.
Alright, what's your deal, bro?
Well, what have we got here? You think you can cross my bridge, do you? Not for free, you ain't.
Okay. Can I...
The troll is bigger than you, stronger than you, and much, much meaner than you. Better not even try it.
Alright, so I'm not gonna stab him, apparently. Can I get him rocks?
You throw a rock at the troll, but it merely bounces off his thick hide. He barely notices it.
Oh, I lost a rock! Well, I didn't lose a point, so I guess I'm still okay. Alright, well, do you want diamond? You know what, before I give away anything else, I don't like the fact that I lost a stone for no reason. Okay, can I give him diamonds? Is that enough?
You give the diamond pouch to the troll, and it appears to satisfy
him. Okay, that works.
He prompts off, leaving the bridge clear for you to cross.
Well, okay, now if you look though, I lost 6 points. So that was not the best way to do that. If you lose points, there's always a better way. So, we will restore the game. And we'll keep my diamonds. I'll come back to you later, bro. Okay, I guess we're going down here. No? Yeah? Okay. Wait, I feel like there should be more. Okay, well, I'm going to go over here. Because I feel like there shouldn't have been all the down area there was. Like, for the next section down. Okay, let's go down here. Okay, let's save this. This looks
there are numerous small rocks and boulders in this part of the forest. There is a moldering old stump here,
ooh,
rotting to pieces. The stump will not move. The rock will not budge. Talking to yourself is a sure sign that the hot heavenry sun is taking its toll on you. It's you, Sir Graham, the finest knight in all of Daventry. You check to make sure that the feather is still securely stuck in your cap.
All right, let's go walk in. Okay, I can't. I see a mushroom over here. Can I just jump?
The raging current pulls you under, never to be found.
Okay, that was not the best option. Alright, let's go left then. Oh, here we go. Here's something. What's this?
This log, felled long ago, awaits the woodcutter's fire. The tree was cut from this stump years ago. Oh. When you look in the window, you see a poor, starving woodcutter and his wife. The chimney seems to be the only part of the cottage that doesn't need repairing.
Okay.
You cannot get the log. You can't do anything with the stump. You can't reach the smoke from where you are standing. This window doesn't open.
All right, well, there's a whole lot of things I can't do. Let's go to the left then. Ooh, I see an axe. I'm assuming I can axe the guy for it? Ha!
It is an ancient, rusty water pump. It probably doesn't even work.
So you think?
The rusty pump doesn't work.
Oh, okay.
That's strange. You don't get an answer.
All right, well, I see an axe.
An old axe is permanently wedged into the tree stump.
All right, well, let's...
The handle has been broken and repaired. The head shows the signs of many sharpenings.
Okay, grab it.
The old axe is tightly wedged in the tree stump. You cannot remove it, no matter what you do.
Okay, so I'm assuming this dude's going to give it to me. Let me just... Should I save it? I always... I'm telling you, when you go screen to screen in this game, you gotta save it, because you don't know what's going to happen in the next screen. Oh, here you go.
The woodcutter speaks to you, his voice broken with sorrow.
We would welcome you to our home, Sir Knight, but we've had no food for so long. My beautiful wife cannot even rise from her bed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Here, she may die soon.
Yeah, I feel you, bro. Ooh!
An old earthenware pitcher sits on the table. You cannot get the pitcher. There is a rickety old cupboard on the wall. If there was something of value in there, the woodcutter and his wife would not be starving to death.
I guess that makes sense. What's this? Is that a violin?
The woodcutter's most treasured possession, a fine old fiddle, lies on the table.
Okay.
You should not steal from these poor people, Sir Graham.
I'll put her out of misery.
You wouldn't want to hurt them.
I kind of do.
You wouldn't want to hurt them.
I really do. This is so hospitable.
The woodcutter sits on the edge of the bed next to his wife. Ever since the woods became too dangerous to venture into, he's not been able to earn a decent living. The woodcutter's poor wife appears to be near death.
Okay, you seem like... Well, let me touch you.
The woodcutter wouldn't appreciate that.
Hey, you don't know what he's into.
The woodcutter probably wouldn't like that.
There's fire.
You warm your hands by the crackling fire.
I was walking into this dude's house. Can I talk to you?
The woodcutter, still gazing at his wife's pale face, does not seem to hear you.
What, you?
The woodcutter's poor wife appears to be near death.
Okay, well, let's see here. Do I have anything that you would want? Oh, what about stones?
You wouldn't want to hurt them.
Okay. Oh wait, diamonds! Duh, he's poor. Okay, I see, I'm at 15 points.
The woodcutter gratefully accepts the treasure.
Thank you, Sir Knight. But I fear that only a gift of food will save my poor wife from starvation.
Okay. Hey! I went down on point. Well, if that's not gonna help you, you can be my fucking diamonds back, you asshole! Ah, oh, Jesus. Alright. Well, fuck you. You're not getting my... There you go. Alright, I can't do anything for you, buddy. She's starving. What are you gonna do? Alright, we're gonna go this way.
You see a clear blue lake surrounded by a pretty meadow.
Okay, so my goal, it looks like, is to collect 3 treasures that have been stolen by Davin, in Draventree. Oh, here's the bridge. Okay, cool. I caught up.
It is an old stone bridge, worn smooth by the ravages of weather and time. If you wish to cross the bridge...
Okay, so it looks like I just need to... Okay, I got a wife of woodcutter that's starving. Got a troll I can't cross. Oh, wait, maybe I can cross this way. Oh, no.
As you start to
There's old the penis
bridge,
nose.
A huge, hulking troll stomp...
Alright.
There are many beautiful trees around... Better not. Those pine needles look sharp.
Okay. Well, let's go this way then. Ooh, this looks pretty.
What a pretty bed of wildflowers. What a pretty bed of wildflowers.
Can I pick it?
There's not much to do there.
Alright, I guess not. Alright, well, that seems meaningless. Ooh! Watch out, Graham! A poisonous snake! Alright, just to be safe.
Large moss-covered trees surround a shallow, swampy lake.
I care about that one, the snake.
A huge snake is watching you very closely, and its intentions are less than friendly. There's no way you're getting that close to the snake. Even if the snake could hear you, it wouldn't have anything to say.
Okay, well, can I... Oh, no, not that way. Hey, snake. Do you want to bite me? No? Can I kill you?
You'll wind up with a useless dead snake and a guilty conscience.
Okay, well, what if I don't want to kill it, then? What if I want to throw a rock at it?
The snake is not interested in any of your possessions.
All right, fine. What's this way? Ooh, I see a hole.
You'll have to move closer.
Okay, well, I will.
The hole appears to go deep down through the rock into the ground below. You can barely make out a faint greenish glow somewhere far inside.
Okay, can I grab it?
You would need to be much smaller to fit through that hole.
Well, unfortunately, I'm not.
That's strange.
So I guess I'll go this way. That tree looks like it's over getting ready to get laid, look. Okay.
There is a small dwarf right nearby.
Okay.
Be careful. This sly little chap is trouble.
Okay, well, what kind of trouble?
That's strange. The sneaky little dwarf caught you by surprise. Did he steal
anything? My 15 points still. I don't know. Did he take anything from me? I don't think he did. But just to be on the safe side...
There is a small...
Okay, well, bye, dwarf. Alright. Random. Okay, oh, this looks kind of interesting.
This is one of the countless rocks and boulders.
Okay.
Some of the rocks poke up from the riverbed. These rocks are actually very tall and treacherous.
Okay, well, let's go down the screen then. Okay, I see something.
There appears to be some sort of bowl sitting next to the tree.
Okay.
You pick up the bowl.
Now what? What does the bowl do?
The small bowl feels rather ordinary. You notice something written in it.
Well, what's written in it?
Inscribed on the inside of this empty ceramic bowl is the word fill.
Okay.
To your astonishment, something begins to bubble up from the bottom of the bowl. Within moments, the bowl is filled with a hot, savory stew.
Okay. That's interesting. I don't really know if I need stew.
This large ceramic bowl is now filled with a savory beef stew.
Can I eat it?
You dip your finger into the stew. It's still hot.
Okay, well, let me eat it.
You eat every bite.
Oh, I lost points!
To your astonishment, something begins to
Okay, well, it looks like it's never-ending food. Wait a minute. Never-ending food. There was someone that needed never-ending food. I forgot who it was.
Bushes and rocks seem to complement each other, don't they?
They do. Okay, well, let's go walk in here and see what we can find. Oh, wait, bridge! Is this penis guy gonna be everywhere? Jesus!
As you start to cross the bridge, a huge, hulking troll stomps in.
Okay, well, I already know your deal. Maybe I can give you food. I don't know if it would do you any good, though.
This appears to be an oversized dwarf maple tree.
Okay.
This tree is too smooth, and there aren't enough footholds for you to climb up.
Okay, well then, I'm not going this way, am I? Oh, I saw a little bird!
This is an attractive meadow.
No, I don't care about that, the birds.
The mother bird is feeding her young in the nest high above you. They're not ready to leave the nest yet. The baby birds don't speak your language. That would be a terribly foolish thing to do.
Oh, these guys make me laugh. Okay, let me save it. Let's go this way then. Wait a minute.
The path to the front door is lined with little gingerbread boys and girls.
Okay, that's not suspicious at all.
The door is made from chocolate. This is the most marvelous house you've ever seen. It seems like it's made of a huge gingerbread cupcake with frosting for a roof. The chimney is made of gummy bricks. The door is made
seems
of
like Hansel and Gretel.
The fence is made of candy canes, and sour ball stones and gumdrops are scattered around the yard.
Okay.
The steps look like they're made out of vanilla fudge, but after years of being stepped on, they've gotten a wee bit filthy.
I'm kind of hungry.
You don't know how long they've been standing there. Eating them probably wouldn't be a wise thing to do. The candy canes are firmly embedded in the ground. You cannot remove them.
Okay, well, I guess worst case scenario. And what could possibly happen here? Let me just save it. A bad feeling.
The door. There is no answer from inside the house.
No? Okay, well, never mind. Oh.
As the green liquid is terribly goopy, the fire must have been burning underneath it for quite some time. The cabinet on the wall is rather plain and simple.
Oh.
You take the cheese from the cabinet.
Okay.
Off of the distance, you hear a high, squeaky voice.
Uh-oh.
I can smell someone tasty in my house.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to get my cauldron ready to cook someone for dinner. Yum. After I get the cauldron nice and hot, I'll be ready to have someone for dinner.
I'm really scared to save it. Okay.
This ugly old witch is one of the most hideous sights you have ever seen. Her eyes are dark and evil, and her crooked smile twitches hungrily. She's not to be trusted. Now is not a good time to try and start a conversation.
Okay.
You need to get...
The cauldron is heating up nicely. I wonder who will be my dinner guest.
The witch sees you.
Oops.
Oh no, she's cast some kind of spell to keep you from escaping.
Oh, how nice of you to come for dinner.
I think I'm supposed to do that.
The witch looks you over carefully.
You're a little too scrawny for my appetite, but I think you're going to make a lovely dessert.
Oh, I can't gingerbread man.
The witch has turned you into a gingerbread man. Or is that a graham cracker?
I see what they did there. Okay. Oh, let me go back. I think I went too far forward. Maybe I could push her?
You need to get...
Oh, it's like Hansel and Gretel.
With a mighty shove, you courageously push the wicked witch into the pot. Her wild screams are suddenly cut off as she melts away into the oily green slime. Congratulations!
Yay? I'm a dick. I just went to someone's house and pushed them into a pot. Well, then again, if she would... Oh, I gained points. Okay, that's good. So we're going to save that as that. Okay.
It's
she deserved
just a plain wooden bedside table. It looks like there's a note lying on top of it.
Oh, well, maybe I should take a look at that note.
Bed looks hard and uncomfortable. You see a note on the table by the bed.
Okay, I'll grab it.
You grab the note from the table.
Okay, I'll read that in a second. Open the drawer.
Try as you might, you can't get the drawer to open.
Okay, well, first off, let's get the hell out of here. Good. So I killed a witch. I guess that's good. Okay, what the hell does this paper say now that I'm safely out of sight?
There is a message written on the note. Sometimes it is wise to think backwards.
Sometimes it is wise to think backwards.
The paper...
Okay, that's... I don't know what that really means. Can't turn it around. Okay. Sometimes it's wise to think backwards.
There is a small dwarf...
No, no! I know you. You steal shit. Okay. Oh! Nuts!
There's a large walnut tree. There's not...
Can I grab a nut? Oh, I can grab a nut! Yay!
You choose a big, meaty-looking walnut from the bunch scattered around.
All right. Can I talk to you?
Not surprisingly, the squirrel doesn't reply.
Can I grab you?
There's not much to do. Please don't bother the squirrel.
Aww.
There's a lot of work to do before next winter.
Okay.
There is nothing up there you'll need.
Oh, maybe more nuts. Can I bite the nut?
You are holding an ordinary walnut.
Okay, well, I'm gonna grab it.
When you open the walnut, you discover the nut inside is pure gold.
Well, it's good for me, I'm guessing, but not good for the squirrel when he has to eat them.
When you open the walnut...
Can I grab it?
The gold walnut feels slightly heavier than an average walnut.
Okay, well, I'm continually gaining points, so this is a good thing. This means I'm doing something right. Okay, well, let's go this way. Oh, wait, this is where the bowl was, so I can go down. Okay, we'll go to the right, because I always like to go right first. Wait, can I swim in there? Let me just save it. I always like to save it. There you go. Nope! That was a good thing I saved it.
Your attempt at cliff diving was a smashing failure.
Ah, I see what I did there. Okay. Oh, damn it!
Your attempt at cliff diving was a smashing failure.
Let's try it again. Let's go this way. There you go. Oh, wait, this is different.
An unusual clover glistens in the middle of the patch.
Oh, what kind of clover?
You pick a large four-leaf clover from the patch.
Okay, well, I gained points. So again, I'm doing something right. Let me see.
You are holding. The clover is very delicate. Don't handle it too much, or you might just damage it.
I don't want to do that. Okay. Well, so far so good. Let's keep going. No, not that way. This way.
The surrounding boulders and trees are reflected on the small mirror-like lake. There are some beautiful, fragile little flowers here by the rocks. You wouldn't want to ruin the beauty of this little lake by picking the flowers.
I kinda do.
The water is not deep enough here for you to dive.
Okay, well, so far, I haven't found any of the treasures, but I'm getting lots of random items. I don't know about this one.
You see the outline of a cave entrance. You see... Don't be afraid.
Okay, well, it says don't be afraid. Yeah, this music's not ominous at all.
It is a huge piece of granite. It's impossible for you to move a boulder this large.
Okay, well... Well, the point of that was... Okay, so far I still haven't found anything. Okay.
These trees are grotesquely bent and twisted, and the branches seem like they're reaching out to grab you.
Okay, sounded creepy there.
There's nothing of interest up the tree.
I don't know, it sounded interesting.
The water of this crystal clear lake is especially cold and crisp. The leprechauns use it to brew their dandelion wine.
Leprechauns?
The water is too shallow here for you to dive into.
Well, I have a four-leaf clover if they want that. Oh, maybe they will. Ooh, I'm thinking ahead. Wait! There's a door.
Don't be afraid. Get close enough for a good look.
Okay. I'm kind of always afraid in this game. You never know what's going to happen.
A huge wooden door has been built into the base of a steep mountain. You notice a large keyhole in the door.
Okay.
The huge door is locked. You can't open it.
Okay.
The only response you get is the echo of your pounding.
Okay, can I...
That's strange. Nothing happened.
All right, well, wait.
This is a miniature shade tree, which gives shade to the squirrels and other woodland creatures. If you remove this tree, you'll be depriving the woodland animals of much-needed shade.
All right, fine. We'll go this way, then. This is where I came down at. See, it's not... The map's not too hard. It's like a giant square, I think, if I remember. Oh, here we go. What's this?
This is a well-tended carrot patch. The carrots look tempting to a hungry traveler.
Okay, let's grab a carrot.
You pluck a...
Ooh, I got points!
...carrot from the ground.
Oh, yummy, yummy. Can I eat it? Or is that bad?
There's nothing like a crisp, fresh carrot.
Oh, I lost points!
You pluck a plump orange...
I got points! Okay, so don't eat the carrot. I learned this. Keep the carrot. Okay. Oh, no, it's this way. Okay, I think I see more...
This is a well-tended carrot patch.
Carrots?
The carrots look tempting to a hungry traveler.
Well, yeah, I mean, what do you...
Nothing...
Okay, I don't mean to use the carrot, I meant to walk. Okay, nothing here. Ooh, what's this?
The goat pen is crudely made of small planks of wood. At the other end, you see a gate.
Okay. Oh, there's a goat. Wait. I don't trust this goat. Okay, well, what's... Am I wrapping around? Okay, see, this is the very first level. Okay. Before I open this, I have a bad feeling about that. Let me just kind of keep going right and exploring first.
Beautiful shade trees abound in this part of Daventry.
Oh.
You can't climb this tree.
Okay. Oh, I see a well.
This weathered old bucket has served the kingdom for years and years. It still holds water as well as it did on the day it was made.
Okay.
A healthy tangle of vines is coiled around the well. This crank is used to lower and raise the bucket into the well. That's straight.
I'm afraid, but I think, you know what, I'm gonna crank this bad boy.
The old bucket disappears into the darkness.
Oh, it's probably a good thing. Anything?
This weathered old bucket.
Is there anything in there? Hey, Graham, what are you doing?
You are in the old bucket. Your weight causes it to slowly descend.
Oh, I guess it's positive points. That's a good thing. Wait, I'm scared again. Okay, well.
The rope is thick and sturdy.
Can I?
You're already climbing. You're all.
Oh, I guess I can climb the rope up and down. I don't know what the point of that would be. Okay, well, can I hop out? No, how do I? Where's my move icon? There we go. Oh, I guess I can't do that. Okay, well, I have to climb.
You check to make sure that.
Oh, oops. Oh, I guess it's okay.
You leap out of the water.
Wait, no. I want the bucket. Wait. I had a bad feeling about this. I was gonna say, let me cut the bucket down.
You can't cut the.
Okay. I guess I can't.
You leap out of.
Okay, let me see if cutting the rope is bad or good. Alright, lose points.
There's a wooden bucket floating in the bottom of the well.
Can I grab it?
You
oh, I got points.
To take the
okay.
You're frantically. You leap out of the.
Okay, so I can still grab the rope. Okay. Okay. So I did something right. I can still go up. I'm still scared. Can I go down? No?
The well water.
Oh! I guess
there's
I can.
Not much.
Oh. Okay, I guess I can. Oh, is this the chest?
It looks like this chest has been buried here for a very long time.
Isn't that one of the treasures?
This isn't the chest you're looking for.
Okay, well, then, sorry. What happened? No, what happened? Hello? Alright, the game glitched out on me, so I had to do this part over again. It actually froze on me when I died, so I gotta ignore that. Like, no joke, it actually legit froze. I didn't even get like a cool saying when I died or anything, it just played music. Okay, so let me save it. That was really weird. Okay. There's a mirror. Okay, now I'm really scared.
Greed and scaly, the dragon is massive and muscular. Serrated armor stretches from its tail to its neck. His leathery wings are folded against his sides, and his webbed claws look sharp and deadly.
Okay.
The ferocious, fire-breathing dragon is protecting the magic mirror. Be careful. Dragons are very dangerous. Think again. When this dragon talks, things have a tendency to catch fire.
Okay.
The mirror shimmers with its own magical light. You'll have to do something about that dragon first.
Okay, well, what if I...
With unerring aim,
oh, the
dagger spins through the air and pierces the soft, unprotected skin under the dragon's throat. The beast convulses for a moment, then crashes, lifeless, to the hard cavern floor.
So here's an example. I gain points, right? So I got 3 points. That's one example of a way I can do this. But this one, I remember exactly what else I can do. So just remember, I'm at 57 points, right? Okay, there's another way to do this. Now that I have the bucket, this is just
you
one...
kneel down and fill the bucket with the cool water.
This is just one I kind of remember. I don't remember why, I just remember it. So remember how I had 57 before if I killed him with a knife? Okay, watch this. Oh, wait.
By venturing too close to the dragon's flame, you made an ash out of yourself.
Ha ha! Oops, I went too close. My bad. Okay, watch. So 57, but there's another way you can do a puzzle. I think this one gives you more points, if I remember.
Good shot. The water hits the dragon square in the face, dousing his fire.
Yeah, I see, I have 61. So you're not required when you beat this game to have the most points. It's just a matter of, there's different ways of thinking. Like, how would I solve this situation? Now, there are some things in this game.
Able to defend itself with anything more than harmless clouds of steam, the dragon rolls aside the granite boulder and slinks off in shame, leaving the mirror behind.
So there are some things in the game you can only do like one or two ways of doing it, but otherwise it's usually three or four. So it's kind of cool because you have different options.
This boulder is a huge chunk of granite.
Of granite? Wait,
this boulder is far too heavy to move. You take the magic mirror. Congratulations!
Well, there's one of three treasures. Okay, let's go this way. What's this way? Oh, wait, I know where this is at. Look. There's that really scary, spooky place. There's an exit, probably. Okay, cool. So, I'm back here. See, I know my way around this place now. Okay, well now I'm no longer scared. I can actually probably... No, I'll leave it on there just for funsies. Okay. See? So again, there's different...
Without warning,
what?
A wolf darts out of the bushes and runs straight for you. Look out! Don't let him catch you!
Well, if he does...
How many times have you been told not to wolf down your food?
I see what you did there. Woo! All right. So like I said, there's different ways of thinking, different ways you can do things. It's one way I always liked about the King's Quest games.
Without warning.
Okay, whoa. Chill. Calm your titties. There you go.
You see lush plant. The bush has done a fine job of surviving by itself so far. Far be it from you to intervene.
I believe with that, I've now mapped out the entirety of Daventry. So basically what that means is I should be able to do everything I could possibly do at this point in time. Meaning the only thing... Oh, you know what? There's one thing I have not done yet. This gate.
The gate to the pen is closed.
Okay, let me open it. Okay. Wait. Should I close it? No, let me just walk this way. Hey, what's up, goat?
The goat is wandering Oh no, the goat has escaped through the gate you left open. He could have wandered anywhere by now.
Oops. Alright, 1 second. I didn't lose points, but I think I probably want to do something with that goat. So
There's not...
Okay, so you need to open the gate. Go inside, close the gate. Okay. See, you gotta use your noodle in this game. Okay, now what can I do with the goat?
Someone has built the goat. There's not much. You wouldn't get very far carrying a goat. Perhaps you can get him to follow you if you'd like to take him somewhere.
How can I get him to follow me? I don't have anything he'd want. Oh! Duh! Wait, yeah, probably, or cheat. No, he doesn't care it.
When you touch the old goat with the carrot,
got it.
He starts to follow you.
Okay, now, I don't know where exactly I would take him. I don't know who exactly would want the goat.
You had better wait for the...
Okay. Who the hell would want the goat? Hell would want a goat? I'll come back to you guys in a second. Wait, where'd you go? There you go. One goat. Oh, you know what?
Goat forgets about your care.
Aw. No, I don't want to lose the goat.
There's not...
Okay, so maybe something closer then.
You'd better wait for...
Because he wandered off on his own, so it's gotta be somewhere close. Maybe this way? Where the hell could I use the goat? Oh! I know where I could probably use him. Maybe?
As you start to cross the bridge, a huge, hulking troll stomps into view and blocks your way. It is a well-known fact that goats hate trolls intensely. You move aside and let the goat take care of this wretched, nasty troll.
All the reason I remember this is Billy Goat's Gruff. Trolls and goats.
The goat lowers his head and runs straight for the troll, butting him right off the bridge and into the river below.
Yeah!
That's the last you'll see of that troll.
I killed him, that's right. I guess you're leaving, goat? Alright, later. Alright, so now I can cross this, which I haven't been here yet. Okay, there's a dude. There's the bridge. What's over here? A rock.
It is a massive boulder.
Okay, well, I don't have very many options left to go. What's down here? Oh, he's just covering this one space, basically. Okay, well, there's gonna be something here I can do then.
This hole, hollowed into the side of the tree, is the entrance to the gnome's home. It's too dark inside to make out any details, and the gnome probably prefers it that way.
Okay, can I go inside?
You weren't invited into the gnome's house. This is a pile of gold. There is a small pile of straw here. This is the gnome's spinning wheel. There's not much to do there. It would not be polite to steal the gnome's pile of gold. You do not need a spinning wheel.
Okay, so basically... I mean, what the hell can you possibly... Rumpelstiltskin?
Welcome, Sir Graham. I've been expecting you. I have something that will be of great use to you. But first, Sir Graham, you must answer this riddle.
Okay.
I'll give you 3 guesses. What is my name?
Rumpelstiltskin. Oh. Oh, how do you spell it? Stiltskin? Is that... I got it! Aha!
Where in the world did you get that idea? That's not even close. You have 2 guesses left.
I don't know what your name is.
You still haven't guessed my name. Ready to take another shot at it? How in the world did you think of that? That's not even close. You only have 1 guess left.
I don't know what your name is.
You still haven't guessed my name. Ready to take another shot at it?
I guess.
Not by a long shot. You didn't guess my name, but I'm going to help you anyway, Sir Graham. Take this golden key. It will aid you on your quest, Sir Graham, but it's up to you to find out how. Well, step over here so I can give it to you. Here you are. Good luck on your quest.
Okay. Well, I guess it didn't matter. I don't know what his name is, but I guess we'll never know. Well, I got a key. Oh! I know where to use the key. Wait! Before I give the key... No, damn it, I didn't mean to push that. I gotta give, where's the starving dude and his wife? Where is that at? I have that bowl thing for him. Remember? Where it looks like it gets unlimited food. And she's starving. Because I'm looking at my list of items, and... That's the only... Where's that? Oh, right there. That's the only thing that would be useful to her. So let me see if I remember where the hell her house is. Is it down here? Yes, here it is.
The woodcutter speaks to you, his voice broken with sorrow.
Oh, Sir Knight, you have returned. But I fear that my wife grows weaker still for lack of food.
Okay, don't worry, bro. I got her some food. I just hope she likes stew.
The woodcutter is overwhelmed with joy.
Thank you. Thank you, Sir Knight. We shall never forget your kindness and generosity. Please, take my fiddle as a small token of our thanks.
Okay. I really wanted the axe instead, but I'll take the fiddle. I got points, I guess. Okay, well, I'm doing something right.
Thank you, Sir Knight.
The woodcutter's wife is too polite to speak with her mouth full. You wouldn't want to hurt them.
You don't know me. Okay, what does the fiddle do?
This is the woodcutter's old fiddle.
Not anymore.
The fine old fiddle has been beautifully carved.
Okay, can I use it?
The woodcutter has little use for that.
Okay, what about me?
The woodcutter has little use for that. You play a lively toe-tapping tune on the fiddle.
There we go.
The woodcutter and his wife ignore your fiddling. Perhaps they preferred their own music.
Oh, okay, well, I guess it's cool. You know, you don't have to like my music, so I'll just go this way. Okay, now I have a key. And there's a stone with a door. Is it here? What the hell is that stone with a door in it? Down? Like, I honestly don't remember where anything is. Oh, there it is. Okay, well, now I got a key.
The only response you get is the echo of your pounding.
Okay, well, guess what, bitches? I got a key.
Using the gold key, you unlock the huge door.
Aha! Okay. Let's do it. Oh, this is like the opening. You know how they're going through the AGD logo? This is the path. So I must be going the right way. Okay, where the hell does this lead, though?
Suddenly, a small dwarf runs out of the shadows and approaches you. The sneaky little dwarf caught you by surprise.
Oh, he better not... Oh, come on! What is a dwarf in this cave for anyways? Okay, I don't know where exactly I'm at now. Okay. This is kind of... I feel like I'm in Dr. Seuss land.
You see a slingshot in the hole.
Oh, okay.
You reach into the hole and pull out the leather slingshot.
All right. I don't really know what a slingshot's going to do for me. But, all right. Wait. What the fuck? What? Wait. How high up in the air was I?
Next time, keep your feet on the ground and your head out of the clouds.
Oh, apparently I'm in the clouds. Alright, well, let's not go right, let's go down. I guess I can't. Oh, wait. Oh, come on!
Next time, keep your feet on the ground and your head out of the clouds.
Okay. Well, let's go up then. Okay, let's go up. Oh, come on! Oh my god! Can I skip this? No? Okay, well, there you go. Story of my life.
Next time, keep your feet on the ground and your head out of the clouds.
All right, I'll try. Okay, I'm gonna go left. Can't see anything. Okay, go down here. Oh, come!
Keep your feet on the ground and your head.
I'm trying to. I don't know where to go. Ah! The hell is this guy?
The enormous giant has been carrying that heavy chest for longer than he can remember. The giant wants to shake more than just your hand.
The chest is the something I need. Isn't that like the...
That's strange. You don't... The giant is in no mood for talking.
The chest, isn't that one of the treasures? Oh, well.
The giant did a smashing job of defeating you.
That'd be cool. Is it? It didn't kill me. Okay. Okay, so what can I use against him? I'm scared. Okay. Dagger?
This is not a good... Getting that close to the giant would be dangerous. Besides, you couldn't reach his weak spot.
Okay. Giant. Diamonds?
The giant with his chest has all the treasure he needs. All he wants from you is to grind your bones to dust.
Oh, come on!
The giant did a smashing job of defeat.
Okay, well...
You don't have time for that. The giant would be upon you before you could even begin playing.
I don't know what else I could do. So, oh, I can slingshot him, maybe. Oh, I guess it's too slow.
The giant did a smashing job. The giant is lying dead on the ground. Beside him is a sturdy chest.
I don't really know where I slingshot it at him. Oh, I guess I shot a rock. Because I'm now minus a rock. I guess, right? Wait, let me double check that. Oh, yes, yeah, I have 5 rocks.
This.
Can I load it myself?
Nothing.
Oh, I guess not. I guess it all uses it. Okay. Aww.
The giant is lying dead on the ground. Beside him is a sturdy chest. The giant is dead. Forget about him and continue your quest.
That's so fucked up, though. It's like he's dead.
It's easy to take the magic chest from a dead giant.
I guess so. I guess that's how we do things here.
You are dazzled by the countless supply of gold coins spilling from the magic chest. You quickly close the chest.
All right, well, I'm 2 out of 3 treasures the way through this.
A dead giant does not have a lot to say.
Okay, well, now where do I go? What's this way?
These weird...
Okay, I don't trust clouds. Well, let me go to the left. That was kind of weird.
Next time, keep your feet on the ground and your head out of...
Okay, well. Well, I feel... That seems weird, though. Why was I able to walk in the clouds here? I should save it first. Nope. Okay, because I clicked left and it went up. That was weird. Alright, well. That's 2 out of 3. So where the hell's the last treasure at? Because I've beaten this game once before, and I remember...
Your head out of the clouds.
I remember it was in a really random... Oh, come on! I just remember it was in, like, a really random area. Because I've gone everywhere I could go, right?
Next time, keep your feet on the ground and your head out of the clouds.
Man, am I missing something? Because I have... Yeah, I have 2 out of 3 treasures. Maybe I can go up. I haven't tried going up here. Oh, come on! Whoa!
Next time, keep your feet on the ground and your head out of the...
Okay. This is the only place I haven't gone up yet. Wait, what? Did he just... What? Did anyone else see him glitch? He was in the ground falling out, not the clouds up high?
Next time, keep
what
your
the hell is going on here? Why is it? Doesn't matter what the game is, it always glitches out for me. In the last game, Sequest I was supposed to do glitched out on me too. Every single game. Alright, let's go back to the main area, I guess.
Suddenly.
No! Run! Oh, come on! How am I supposed to escape from that shit? That was bull. There we go. I was like, come on, he chased me like right after I got out of that cave. Okay. I don't really know where else I can go. And this is what usually happens towards the end of a King's Quest game. You think you've gone everywhere. So there's got to be somewhere.
As you reach out to open the door.
Oh. Well, you got to figure there's got to be somewhere you can go. But you're always like, well, I've done everything there is, so where else can I possibly go? This, like I said, this always happens in King's Quest games. You just gotta, kind of toughen it out and just kind of walk around until you find something. Usually, you'll know you're in something right because something will happen, an event you haven't seen yet, or okay, like this for example. That was really random. What is this?
Gentle Sir Graham, I am your fairy godmother. Your quest is indeed noble. What little aid I can offer you is this protective magic spell, effective for but a short while. I shall be watching over you, Sir Graham.
Okay. So I did something. Although I didn't get points for it. So if something happened and you don't get points for it, it's non-essential. Meaning that you don't have to. It might be points to get something that's like the best way to do something. Like, you'll get more points, but it's not... It doesn't matter. It really doesn't. Where the hell am I supposed to go? Okay, let's keep walking the countryside until something pops up. Something's bound to pop up somewhere. Many time now. All right, come on, Graham. Just wander the countryside till you find something you want to do. Nope. I can't go that way. Come on, there's gonna be something you can do, boy. Come on.
Ye best be careful, young Graham. The mystic protective spell of mine has weakened and departed.
It didn't lose points. That was just something random. Maybe I could have used that earlier if I had gotten there earlier. Alright, let's keep going. Wait, what? Guys, this is playing weird music, so I'm just gonna take a look at this. Wait.
You see the outline of a cave entrance. This is a large condor. Its graceful flight appears effortless. At times, it dives so low you can practically touch it.
Can I? Apparently, I suck at this. Oh, it left. Does it come back? Okay, so this obviously has to be what I'm supposed to do.
Don't be afraid.
I'm not afraid, I'm trying to jump on this stupid... Trying to time this, it's hard.
Don't be afraid, just
I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid of the cave. Ah, oh, damn it. This is obviously what I'm supposed to do. Because, see, it keeps coming back. I don't know what it's going to do. Okay, I don't know how I'm supposed to time this.
With a mighty
leap, I got it.
You grab hold
wow.
of the condor's talons.
I did that. I was like, because I kind of remember there being a bird I had to climb on it. See, shit like that, like... You had to really sit there and, like, you have to try and try and try. Look how long it took me to do that. I don't know where the hell it's taking me. Okay, well, I guess I'm here at a hole. Well, I guess I'm not really scared anymore. Well, just in case, I'll just do regular. Okay.
Don't be afraid. You need to be... Perhaps you should explore your surroundings before going down there.
Okay, so I'm assuming that would normally be a dead-end area. I can't do anything here. Why would this be a dead-end area normally? Oh, that's why.
You pick the mushroom.
Oh, the mushroom's supposed to do. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, for example, had I done this and not, and I got in the hole, I'm guessing that's where I'm going, probably, right? Yeah, I'm guessing had I done that and I didn't grab the mushroom, I would have been stuck here and I couldn't beat the game. Maybe I would have started the whole thing over. It's not a long game, but it's just tedious. That's why a lot of people usually do multiple save spots like what I was doing. But because it doesn't force you to do anything, it's kind of cool.
There is a single torch on the wall, illuminating the shadowy cave. The torch is too hot to touch.
Alright, well, let's go this way.
There is a single torch on the wall. This is a big...
I like the fact that there's a rat down here.
...and long, sharp claws. Keeping in mind the rat's remarkable agility and even more remarkable fangs, you decide not to risk an attack.
Hello there, my friend. Are you looking for anything in particular? You want to pass through my little door here, right? Well, maybe we can work something out. What's it worth to you?
I don't know.
Hey, friend, you wanna go through this door? Make me an offer, and I'll promise I'll let you breeze right through. Hey, friend.
Okay. Well, since I'm assuming, because I got the mushroom for a reason, maybe I can give him the mushroom?
Come a little closer. I can't reach it.
Okay.
The rat grins crookedly.
Wait.
His long, pointed fangs glistening in the torchlight.
That's right, mister. Just walk a little closer.
I don't trust him. I don't know why. Oh, that'd be why.
Rats. This was one shady character you shouldn't have tangled with.
Aha, rats! Alright, well... Do you want a mushroom?
What are you trying to do? Jimmy with a measly offering? What an insult!
Okay, wow. Maybe a knife?
In the dim light, your aim would suffer. Better find a less violent way to get past this dirty rat.
Okay, what the hell would a rat want? Oh. That's cheese, right, I think?
This is an extremely fragrant piece of Swiss cheese.
Well, I'm never getting that at the witch's place, so let me cheese him, see if that works.
Cheese, eh? Well, yeah, now that you mention it, I guess I am kind of hungry.
The rat drools at the sight of the cheese and snatches it from your hand. You might want to count your fingers.
Okay. Oh, there we go. Making progress here.
It looks...
The hell are these guys?
Oh no, there are two leprechaun guards here, and they don't look pleased to see you at all. What are you going to do now?
I don't really know.
They are tiny people dressed all in green. Don't even try it. They're more agile than you are, and they outnumber you. Unfortunately, you don't speak the language of the little folk.
Okay, so what's the worst that can happen?
With a genuine four-leaf clover in your possession, the leprechauns fear and respect you. Rather than risk offending you, they decide to leave you entirely alone.
Okay. Well, I guess that's...
Carved into the top of this stone pillar is a huge four-leaf clover. Apparently, the leprechauns who inhabit this underground sanctuary greatly fear and respect the power of the four-leaf clover.
Okay, well...
You can't move the pillar. The leprechauns, sensing the power of your four-leaf clover, begin to vanish.
All right. Well. Okay.
The shield is made of titanium and is rimmed with jewels.
Don't mind if I do.
You take the magic shield. Congratulations!
Okay, I don't get why the mushroom was important then.
The small hole leads. You are much too big to fit through that small
hole. Oh! Don't tell me if I eat the mushroom I turn small like Alice in Wonderland.
You eat the mushroom.
What is that, a Mario sound?
Congratulations! You now have all three of Daventry's lost treasures. Now, don't waste any time. Bring the treasure straight back to King Edward before it's too late.
Okay, well, I believe this is where the game ends. So let me... I think... Don't mind if I do. Aha!
The portcullis is the only entrance to the king's castle. That's odd. Why aren't the guards at their posts?
This is true.
More curious still, the courtyard is deserted. This area is usually filled with the ladies and lords of the castle. This is highly unusual. You begin to feel deeply disturbed, as if all is not
I don't know what happened.
In the castle. You can faintly hear a commotion in the king's chamber to the west.
There is nothing to be done.
Uh-oh.
Oh, our king's melancholy is too much for his heart to bear. If only Sir Graham had returned with the three lost treasures of Daventry.
Oh, but little did you know I did!
It's Sir Graham!
He's returned.
Did he find the treasures?
Shh.
Listen.
Your Highness, I am at your service.
Did you succeed in your quest?
I did, Your Majesty. Here, as you commanded, the magic mirror.
From the dragon.
The magic shield.
From the dwarf, or the leprechauns.
And the magic chest.
From the giant. Oh no!
I'm afraid it is a little too late for me, but you have done superbly, my knight. As I promised, the crown is yours. I know you will serve this kingdom well.
The king is dead. Long live the king!
Long live the king!
Well, that was a crummy right in front of the dead king that's still lying on the ground.
And thus ended Sir Graham's quest for the lost treasures of Daventry. Despite the loss of their beloved King Edward, the people of Daventry grew happy and prosperous for years to come. And whenever King Graham looked into his magic mirror, he saw visions of adventures yet to come for him, for his children, and for Daventry, the land he loved so much.
And there you have it. That is King's Quest 1, Quest for the Crown. Yes, it's not the most long game in the world. That's not even English. It's not the longest game in the world, but it's a great game. It's a fun game. And again, there's different ways of doing things. So even as a kid, like, you might be like, oh, maybe I should just give, let me just stab the dragon in the neck and kill him. And that works. And then you can get out via the rope. Or you can douse him with water, which is more clever against a dragon who breathes fire. You know, that's cool. There's different ways to do it. I know in the past when I used to walk through on the original DOS-based game. The first time I played this, I got stuck with the guy, the name, when I did it with no dead ends. And I think it was something crazy, and you don't normally get a key from him otherwise, I don't think. I don't know. Either way, I love this game, I love the series, so in between games where you guys are choosing games for me to play, I will continue to play King's Quest in the order of the games. Next is King's Quest 2, which I've beaten one time, but I don't think that one doesn't have the option for no dead ends, so I might get stuck a few times. But I'll just skip ahead if it happens and cut the video where it needs to be cut, so that way it's not watching me play the game like 10 times. Alright, that was it. So I want to thank you guys for watching. I got a 124 out of 158. I don't know if I can do any more cleverness than that. Aw, thank you guys for introducing us. Alright guys, and that's King's Quest, Quest for the Crown. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to vote for my next game in the series you guys picked the game for me to play. And we will see you guys later. This is Game of Master 01. I'm out of here, y'all.